As we reported, Dallas police used a robot equipped with an explosive device to kill suspect Micah Johnson. It appears to be the first time U.S. law enforcement has used a robot to deliver lethal force. Our coverage continues here with CBS 2's Tony Aiello.
Oh, I saw that blow up.
It is a tool hundreds of police agencies have used for decades. Developed by the military, remote control robots have increasingly advanced capabilities.
The technology really has developed in recent years.
It's amazing. You look outside my office, there's a steep stairwell, and there's robots that can actually climb that stairwell.
Edmund Hartnett is an NYPD veteran who also served as commissioner of police in Yonkers, which has its own bomb squad robot.
The robot goes in, so a human or even a canine doesn't have to go in.
He believes Dallas Chief David Brown made a tough but necessary call to end last night's violence.
We saw no other option but to use our bomb robot.
This video shows the Dallas Bomb Squad robot in use last summer, exploding pipe bombs left in a van. Chief Brown says overnight, negotiations with Micah Johnson broke down, and they decided to end the standoff with the robot.
Place a device on the its extension for it to detonate where the suspect was. Other options would have exposed our officers to grave danger.
Hartnett says it's possible the Dallas chief sought legal advice before giving the order. He compares it to authorizing a sniper to take out a gunman.
If you have a shot, take it. In this case, the sniper, you replaced a police sniper with a robot.
This is an individual that killed five police officers. Why put more officers' lives at risk?
Commissioner Bratton says he supports the decision made in Dallas, and the NYPD has the technology to do the same thing here if necessary. Tonight, some experts are raising concerns about this new way to neutralize a threat, calling for a full review of the decision to deliver lethal force using a robot. Others say they don't expect police to use robots in this manner, except in extreme cases. Dana.
Tony, thank you.